So Matthew, thank you for coming again. I'm glad you're here.
Thank you.
Thank you. I want to remind you that, just like I reminded you last week for the first session, we are recording it for educational purposes. However, I do have to let you know that if I think that you are in danger of hurting yourself or others, then for your own safety and for the safety of others, it is my duty to report it just to make sure you are safe and also everybody else.
Okay, no problem. Okay. I understand.
Okay, so Matthew, I do notice that you came in today a little less anxious, a little less tense. Has something changed this week from last week?
Yeah, I went to stay with a friend of mine. I mean, I haven't really spoken to my father, but I am still disappointed and still mad. I got the homework that you asked for, so
okay.
Here's the drawing.
Okay, thank you. Okay. Well, first, Matthew, I think that by making the choice at staying at your friend's house has helped you feel less tense. And I think that it's important that you are being able to identify that you have a support system around you, such as your friend. And if it's making you feel better, then it's something that it's good to have, especially going through the situation you're going through right now with your father.
Yep.
However, you do say that you are less tense. Is that correct?
Yeah, I would say I'm a little less tense.
Okay, but you are still angry at your father.
That's correct.
So what do you think it's still holding you back from having that conversation with him?
I don't know. I'm not very good at expressing my feelings. So I drew the picture as you asked for. And
okay.
Basically, I mean, the colors are going to represent, black is going to represent the anger.
Okay.
The red is gonna be disappointment,
mm-hmm.
And the brown is gonna represent sadness.
Okay, I see. Well, it can be difficult to express what we aren't sure what we are feeling. And just like you mentioned, the last session, you were having this difficulty. However, just by releasing some of those feelings onto paper, you are able to express them. You may not always have to use words, but you were able to use a different method, which also helps you to identify what's going on in regards to your father's relationship. Okay. I do think that you do wish to continue the relationship with your father and maintain it. And I think with the homework, it is helping you to show that transition and that growth from that prior session that we had. Going forward, how comfortable would you be contact your father again?
Well, going forward, I do feel the homework was successful in helping me elaborate on feelings I otherwise would never express.
Mm-hmm.
And I mean, going forward, communicating with my father could be a good idea, and I think I would communicate with him and see where that takes me.
Okay, well, that sounds good. I think you are motivated and continue using this form of self-expression to identify those feelings. I also want to identify that by utilizing this form of expression, you are being able to reach into those feelings that perhaps in some other moment or situation you wouldn't have been able to express, like you just did just now with me. Is that correct?
That is correct.
Okay. Correct. Okay. Okay, so for the next session, I would be interested in seeing and hearing what came to mind or what maybe rised after you contacted your father, and we can take it from there to see if something has changed or if there's something that is coming up that you would also like to talk about.
Okay.
How does that sound?
That sounds good.
Okay.
All right, so I look forward to seeing you again.
Okay, thank you.